Hello and welcome. This will be the video for problem number 7 of my Python midterm. This one was a little interesting. Took a little bit of figuring out, but let's see, we are given, let's copy this over. So this as our starter code, and honestly it didn't format very great, so I had to all this. This typo satis positive for there we go. Cool. Okay. Formatting fixed. There we go. Formatting fixed. And then we were given a few other things. So satisfies F is the one we're going to be completing. So we'll actually do something like okay. Okay, there we go. So that's where we will start our code. We're given a few other things though. We're given this as a photo, so I have to type it in manually. So that's and L equals A. Then our running result will look like this. So as if. But before we actually run that, I'm going to do this code up here. So what we can do here is, since we are looking at L, we can where it says mutate L such that it contains all the strings originally in L. Seems like we're going to be making a new list, so there. Yeah. Well, we have L and then we have list because they're kind of the same. Anyways, so copy of each element in L, and then with that we can do a loop, a for loop, for each element in list. So originally in L such that fs returns false. So we're going to do if the fs returns bits from the actual list and that. Then I should be able to run that, and that is the opposite of what we were doing. We're supposed to get for our running results. So since it's keeping A, we should be able to change this. And that gives us the correct running results. So that will be problem number 6. Oh, problem number 7. Oops, my bad. I may have misspoke at the beginning of this as well. That was problem 7. I believe that is the last one for us. And thank you for joining me. Whew, I'm gonna save this. And then I double check everything, and I should be good to turn it all in. So thank you again, and I'll see you next time.